Generally speaking, you're free till you're about 4 years old. Then you go to grammar school, and then you start becoming demented and solved. You lose what individualism you have. If you have enough, of course, you retain some of it. But most don't have enough. So you become watchers of game shows, you know, and things like that. And you work the 8-hour job with almost a feeling of goodness, like you're doing something. And you get married like marriage is a victory, and you have children like children is a victory. But most things most people do are a total grind. Marriage, birth, children. It's something they have to do because there's nothing else to do. There's no glory in it, there's no steam, there's no fire. It's very, very flat. And the earth is full of them. Sorry, but that's the way I see it.
We want to get everything down as fast as possible. We want to convert the rhythms and the skills of work into cash, which indeed you can buy something with, but you can't eat it. Then rush home to get away from work and begin the real business of life, to enjoy ourselves. And, you know, for the vast majority of American families, what seems to be the real point of life, what you rush home to get to, is to watch an electronic reproduction of life. You can't touch it. It doesn't smell, and it has no taste. You might think that people getting home to the real point of life in a robust material culture would go home to a colossal banquet, or an orgy of lovemaking, or a riot of music and dancing. But nothing of the kind. It turns out to be this purely passive contemplation of a twittering screen. You see mile after mile of darkened houses with that little electronic screen flickering in the room. Everybody isolated, watching this thing. And thus, in no real communion with each other at all. And this isolation of people into a private world of their own is really the creation of a mindless crowd. And so, we don't get with each other, except for public expressions of getting rid of our hostility, like football or prize fighting. And even in the spectacles one sees on this television, it's perfectly proper to exhibit people slugging and slaying each other, but oh dear no, not people loving each other, except in a rather restrained way. One can only draw the conclusion that the assumption underlying this is that expressions of physical love are far more dangerous than expressions of physical hatred. And it seems to me that a culture that has that sort of assumption is basically crazy and devoted, unintentionally indeed, but nevertheless in fact devoted, not to survival, but to the actual destruction of life.